Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, today we are going to see one of the most important methods for softening the water, that is converting hard water into soft water. And this method is nothing but the lime soda process. Let us see in detail what all actually happens in this process. Lime soda process. In this process, lime. So what exactly lime is? It is CaOH twice, also known as calcium hydroxide, and Na2CO3, that is sodium bicarbonate, are used to soften the water. By this method, both temporary and permanent hardness of water can be removed. Bicarbonates and carbonates are removed by lime, whereas sulfates and chlorides are removed by soda. Now, bicarbonates and carbonates are the minerals which are present in water and which are responsible for the temporary hardness of water. When I talk about the sulfates and the chlorides, those are the minerals which are also dissolved in water, but they are responsible for the permanent hardness of water. In this method, we are going to remove both the temporary and the permanent hardness of water. Let us go through the reactions of it. So I have CaHCO3 thrice, and the whole thing is twice, plus CaOH twice, forming 2CaCO3, which is nothing but a precipitate, plus 2H2O. Now this is my product. If you look carefully, the product has two things. The one thing is precipitate and second thing is pure water. So pure water can be removed out and this precipitate can be filtered away. Let us look at the balancing of the reactions. Over here I have calcium. Over here also I have calcium, which is twice. Why? Because in the reactant side I have Ca and Ca, and over here I have 2Ca. When I see this, this is HCO3, the whole thing twice. Let us only focus on H as of now. The hydrogen. The hydrogen is twice over here. Plus I have CaOH twice. So over here also I have hydrogen, which is twice. So over here 2 and over here 2. This 2 and this 2 will sum up to become 4. So I have 4 hydrogens on the reactant side. Let us see the product side. Over here I do not have any hydrogen, but over here I have H2 twice. So twice H2 is nothing but 2 into 2, which is 4. The number of carbons over here is 1 into 2, which is 2. And over here I have 2 carbons. Now oxygen is very interesting over here. If you look carefully, I have O3 twice. O3, the entire O3 is twice. That means 3 oxygen and those 3 oxygen twice. So that is the reason why we will multiply this 2. So this is nothing but 6 times O plus O2. Over here I have OH twice, so this will be 2. So 6 plus 2, which is 8. So over here let us see what do we have. I have O3 twice. So again 3 2s are, which is 6. And over here plus 2, which is 8. So this entire reaction is balanced and it forms a precipitate plus water. Let us move on to the next reaction. I have MgHCO3 twice plus CaOH twice, forming CaCO3 precipitate plus MgCO3 precipitate plus twice H2O. Over here also on the reactant side, if we observe very carefully, we find that CaCO3 is a precipitate. MgCO3 is also a precipitate, and plus I have formation of pure water. So it forms precipitates and pure water. So pure water remains as it is. The precipitate can be filtered away. Now let us look at the balancing of the equation. I have Mg over here. On the entire reactant side, I only have 1 Mg. On the entire product side also, I have 1 Mg. Then again, as similar to the previous one, we have HCO3 twice plus CaOH twice. So now H over here is 2, H over here is 2. So 2H plus 2H forms 4H, which is 2H2. 2 into 2 is also 4. Then over here I have carbon, which is twice. Over here if we see, I have 1 carbon over here and 1 carbon over here. So this 1 plus 1 is again 2. Then the oxygen O3 twice plus O2. So O3 twice is nothing but 6 and O2 is nothing but 2. 6 plus 2 is 8. So over here there should be 8 oxygens in all. Let us see. I have 3 over here and 3 over here. So 3 plus 3 is 6 plus 2O. So 3 plus 3 is 6 plus 2 is 8. So 8 over here and 8 over here. Finally, we have one thing left, which is calcium. Over here also calcium is 1. Now let us have a look at the third and the last equation. that is MgCO3 plus CaOH twice, forming CaCO3 plus MgOH twice. Where if we see, again we get CaCO3, which is nothing but a precipitate. Let us look at the balancing of this equation. I have Mg over here, Mg over here as well. So 1 Mg and 1 Mg. Calcium is also 1 and 1. 1 calcium over here, 1 calcium over here. Carbon is also 1. Over here also carbon is 1. Now let us look at the number of hydrogens and the number of oxygens. First let us look at the number of oxygens. I have O3 and O2. Over here also I have O3 and O2. So we have 3 plus 2 which is 5. Over here also 3 plus 2 which is 5. And lastly the number of hydrogens, that is H2. Over here also I have H2. So both the hydrogens are also balanced on both the sides. Let us see at the balancing of both the reactant and the product side of this reaction. So I have CaSO4. So Ca calcium is 1 over here on the reactant side, which is the same on the product side. Over here also I have calcium as 1. SO4, so S sulfur is 1 over here. We do not have sulfur over here at all. Over here also we have S sulfur as 1. Let us count the number of oxygens. Over here we have O4 plus O3. So 4 plus 3 which is 7. And over here also O4 and O3. 4 plus 3 which is 7. And the oxygens are also balanced on both the reactant and the product side. Now let us see the sodium, which is Na, Na twice. Over here also I have Na twice. C over here is only 1, carbon is 1 on the reactant side, and carbon is 1 on the product side as well. Now let us see the second reaction, which is CaCl2 plus Na2CO3 forming CaCO3 precipitate plus 2NaCl, which is a salt. So the byproduct formed over here are salts and precipitates. Precipitates can easily be filtered out from the water, and salts which are neither acidic nor basic, and so because of that salts can also easily be removed from the water, making the water ultimately pure water. Let us just have a look at the balancing of this reaction, the reactant and the product side. Over here I have calcium which is 1, on the product side also I have 1 calcium. Chlorine is twice on the reactant side, there is no more chlorine on in this reactant. Over here also I have 2 Cl, so chlorine is also twice here. Sodium Na is 2, over here also I have 2 Na. C 1, over here also I have 1 C. And then O3. Over here also I have O3. So this is also a balanced reaction. Lime soda process can be carried out either in cold water or in hot water. If the process can be carried out in hot water, then it is known as hot lime soda process. If the process can be carried out in cold water, then it is known as cold lime soda process. So over here in this video, we studied the introduction to lime soda process, how it is carried out and how important it is to convert the hard water into soft water. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda and subscribe to Ekeeda.